Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today I'm going to show you how to make a track similar to the beat Meek Mill hopped on for his diss track against The Game. So this beef or diss track competition, we've had a couple before, like Kendrick versus like everybody. We had Drake versus Meek. Now we have Meek versus Game. So who's next? I don't know. Hip hop's always a little bit more fun when the competition kind of raises up a bit more. It's a little more fun when there's some tension there. Now, as far as the actual beef and violence and all that, I'm not a fan of it. It's just a different atmosphere when you have tension in hip hop. I think it starts to breed new genres. It breeds new techniques. It breeds a new sound. So it's always something positive coming out of it, even though it seems chaotic. So the sound we're starting to shift to is more 90s hip hop. If you notice their tracks, they're not on like typical trap beats. They're on like these, kind of sample beats, and then Game's on like a different style West Coast beat. Okay. So it's not like your typical trap beat. And I think if you remember Kendrick versus everybody basically on Control, Dito, Nananino, you know, remember that song? that also wasn't really a trap beat. So when we bring attention to these songs, and also Back to Back had a lot of that bass sliding, and that was super huge. So that's kind of what carried the culture. Now we're starting to put so much attention on these guys that now we have new techniques. So now the attention is not going to be so on trap beats anymore. Chances are, I'm just guessing, but that's kind of what history has told us. So enough talking about my opinion on the beef. What we're going to get into is how to create the sample feel without actually being samples, without actually using samples. Let's open up Keyscape for the retro keys. I found these keys to be the best for especially retro stuff like e-pianos. I'm going to open up an e-piano. So the sample is like, you know, it's just playing two notes over and over again. So let's go to Vintage Digital Keys. I'm going to switch it out for something and wait for this to load up. So as that's loading, to make it feel sampled, we're gonna add human flaw to it as if it were played by hand, or you could just play it by hand. And then we could convert it to audio so we could slice it into the playlist, and I'll show you why that's important. Now this is a little too crystally. I probably shouldn't have picked this one. Let's do the hybrid digital grand. See what this sounds like. We need something more chorusy. So lastly, I'm going to try the MKS-20. You could always add effects and different things later. We're not going to worry about the actual tone. I just need an e-piano to understand the vibe of it. Turn on my speakers a little bit. Okay, so since that's loading up, let's go to BusyWorksBeats.com for drums. And let's go to the Ultimate Producer Bundle number 2. Let's go to the Fire Drum Kit to open up some kicks. So I want a kick that's nice and short, because we're going to do a lot of bouncing around. That one's short, but it has a longer sustain type of sound. So let's go to kick hot. Let me see what else we got. That actually might be a better kick. Kick 3, even though it's a little saturated as far as its sound, we can always add a filter to it. Okay, now we need a snare that's very short as well. So here we have one. Okay, so it's gonna go boom, clap. So it's a lot of bouncing. Boom, clap, clap, boom, clap, boom, clap, clap, boom, clap, 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 boom. So that's the pattern. So we've done bounce snares before. It just increases the activity and the energy of the song. Boom, clap, clap, boom, clap, 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 boom. So for the kick, I'm going to shorten it a bit, turning up the fade parameter so it's a little bit shorter. Now you can add another snare in there if you want. I'm not going to take this and focus on minutia. Whoops, I thought that was the keys. Sorry about that. And all we need now is just an open hi-hat to add more energy to it. So I think, do we have any opens? Let's go to the X kit at busyworksbeats.com. Let's open up the hi-hats. We have open hi-hats in here. And I'm going to add that open hi-hat over top the some of the snares. Now, the important part is that I want this to be sound like a sample. So I'm going to turn the hold parameter all the way up. Okay, so I have it playing every now and then. I don't have it playing every single hit. Now for this, I'm going to send it to piano roll because I only want it to play for the note length. That's why I turn that hold parameter up. It will only play for the time I hold the key. So if I let it go a little bit earlier, it plays shorter. And that's important because I don't want the whole sample to play out every single time. I want it to feel like it's a sample. So that's just to add brightness to the actual snare. Okay, so that's the drum pattern. I'm not going to change it too much. Let's go inside the playlist. And now we're just going to lay out the da 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 da. Now I'm not going to copy the notes because of the original song. So we're going to have to do something different. It might change the mood a bit. So just a slight, you know, precautionary disclaimer. It might change the mood because once you change the notes, sometimes it just takes it out the vibe. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. So let's do something else. Let's change the timing here to 1/3 beat. That's how we got the da 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 da. That's not quarter timing. It's 1, 2, you know. So let's. It's kind of like turning the swing parameter on. Now I'm going to change the tonality of the notes. So let's turn the volume down. So I'm going to make this seem like it's a sample. Dun, 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 boom, boom, boom. I think that's from a jazz song somewhere. I can't remember. Let's pull it back to a third beat. Can barely hear it, so let me turn up the volume. The reason I turn the velocity down is because when you play it heavier, it plays a barky type of tone. When you play it soft, it doesn't add that bark type of sound. Now I just have to get the timing right here. So if you want this to sound like a sample, open up Edison in your mixer track. And what I like to do is go inside piano roll, add another note somewhere over here. So you have a little tail at the end because it will repeat itself and it's harder to find sample positions. So just hit record in Edison on your track that you have the piano routed to. And now you can hit stop. So that's why I added that note over here just so it had time to kind of cool down. And now we have it as an audio clip. I'm just going to drag it into the playlist. And all we have to do from this point is treat it as if it were a sample. You don't have to have it, you know, finished. So for example, if you wanted to cut it off, let's go to snap the grid none. And let's see, here's where we turn around. Actually right here. So let's say you just wanted to repeat it over and over again. Hit shift, pull it over. Or you can time stretch it. I mean, whatever you want to do. Click stretch, stretch it out for that last little piece. That's a little sloppy. I don't like that. But you could, that's an option for whatever you come up with. Make sure you take off time stretching. Okay, it's extremely important. So now we have that kind of gap. If you listen, there's a mute in between, and that adds to that sample type of feel. Whereas if we just played it as MIDI, it wouldn't have that kind of stop and go effect because the reverb would carry it on. So that's how we get the sample feel. We convert the MIDI into audio. That's one technique. So let's send that to track 5. And let's add our drums. I think we're at pattern 2. No, pattern 1 with the drums. Now the one note hits a little early, so I'm going to manually move it over. Slice that out. So here's what you can do with audio. I mean, you could be really precise. So all I have to do now, change it back to bar mode, delete all this stuff, highlight it, hit shift, left click and drag. So now we have all those slices. A lot of people like to crossfade and do all this type of stuff. You could change it to mode inside your sample. Go to crossfade bleeding, which means every time we made it cut, it will create a crossfade. Now the thing is, you got to make the samples a little bit shorter or else it's going to play the whole thing out. Notice it's playing a dun 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 dun. So let's, if you're that tedious and worried about clicks and pops, if you have clicks and pops in your samples, I didn't hear any, but there could be some ghost clicks and pops I don't hear. So this is why we use crossfading, so that we create a zero phase point without, going from 1 to 0 really quickly. It creates a pop sound. Now here it's fading all over the place, so we need to cut it back. Now this is the one thing I don't, it's confusing, is because it overlaps and it looks confusing to other people. Notice that volume dip, so we're going to drag it out further. So let's copy that over with all these new fades. Hit shift. I'm just going to move them in two different columns so you can see the differences. Now let's add some effects. I meant to add it inside of Omnisphere Keyscape, but I didn't load it up in Omnisphere. So we need some kind of chorusing or phasing. So let's add a fruity phaser effect. Let's add a little tiny bit of fruity delay, ping pong mode. Turn that volume down, turn the feedback up. That's really the whole beat. Other than that, there's a sub bass. So let's open up 3x OSC. Let's turn off oscillators 2 and 3. Let's send this to the track 6. And we're just going to play this at a very low octave. So we're going to turn down our coarse pitch down 2 octaves and just play bass notes. And let me turn up my monitors because I can barely hear the keys. So your job right now is just to make the keys feel like they're in the background. One thing they did was add a filter during certain sections. So I'm going to open up a parametric EQ2, change it to a low pass filter. And they had that run a couple bars. So let's right click, create an automation clip. And I want that to run in the next 8 bars. So let's stretch our automation clip out, turn off the mix level. So at 0, that means we have no filter. At 100%. That means we do have our filter. So the filter kicks in at after 8 bars. And you can readjust the cutting and everything. So our job is just to make it sound more ambient and kind of sampled. So let's go to an aux track. We're going to open up a digital reverb this time, not my usual impulse response based reverbs. Let's see. I need a better digital reverb. I use UAD a lot, but it might cause lag. So So let's open up Lexicon 224. If it causes too much lag, I'm not gonna worry about it. But I like to switch it to a large hall environment. And let's send this track to the aux track. So now it has a reverb tail to it. I'm gonna turn up the time for the mids, so it lasts a little bit longer. The one cool plugin you can use, I'm not sure. I think Guitar Rig might have this effect. Let me see. Just to triple check. Let's go to Guitar Rig. Let's go to Components. Make sure you turn your input to left and right so you have stereo inputs, or else you're going to get a mono signal. And let me see if we have any type of vibrato for pitch. Let's go to Pitch. I don't see any modulation. It might be under here. So modulation you want to look for, like Electric Lady for chorusing. There's a phaser in here. Oh, this is a flanger, sorry. So you get that kind of retro 80s sound. They used a lot of phasers, a lot of flangers, and a lot of chorus. Rotator is a little bit different, creates like an organy type of sound. Organy. What's the plugin I'm looking for? I don't think they have. You could probably set it up. You're probably gonna have to use a modifier and do all this type of stuff, which is probably confusing for you. But what we're doing is I want to pitch vibrato. So there's a plugin by UAD. Haven't used it in a while. Ampex ATR. You can turn up what's called the wow parameter, and it does a pitch bend. It's like adding vibrato to your whole audio sample. And I like that kind of pitch bending effect. Makes it more 80s-ish. Now these sound too early. They sound too on the grid, the first two samples. So I'm gonna move those over just a bit by going to snap to grid, none, hitting shift right twice, or you can move it with your mouse manually to pull it to the right. One, two, three, four. I think we have too much pitch bending, so let me turn down the wow parameter. So your goal now is just to make it sound wide. Let's add that sub bass on pattern three. Now, what I like to do is I like to hear my bass first. A lot of people like to feel their bass, but you can create musical issues sometimes. So I'm gonna produce the bass in a higher octave and then transpose it down to a lower octave. So G is gonna be that first bass note. Let's turn that velocity back to normal because FL Studio memorizes the velocity from your last note. And everything else, like panning and different whatever. So here I'm gonna use a half step, boom, boom, boom. Nice short little notes. So I want to go boom, 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 boom. So I'm just following the patterns of the kick and the snare. So let's drop this down an octave. I like it down one more octave because I like the, let me see. There we go. Now I'm just focused on making this piano sound cooler. original song, they had like a a live bass kind of do like a fall down the scale. So we can add that in. Let's open up Trillion. Now, I didn't want to copy the notes exactly, so you're getting the same sounds, but it's a slightly different vibe. Okay, but we can't be copying these songs for many different reasons. So let's go to electric fingered bass. I'm just going to click on the first option, which is a Fender. And the bass they had sound sampled. All it was doing was going down the scale. Let me turn off the bass for a second. You know, it kind of fell at the end. So here, let's add that in. Let me slide this over. So now that the live bass, I thought it was going to be able to play. Just got to wait till it can produce a tone. Takes a while to load up these libraries because they're so detailed, but that's fine. And we're just going to go down the scale. Now you have the option to convert it into audio if you want, but this one we don't need to be so tedious. Let's add a compressor to the snare, Fruity compressor. Want to see if it's giving us more character. Hold on. Sounds the same, so I'm not going to use the compressor for what I was going to use it for. Okay, so now let's just go down the scale with the bass. I like the muted sound when you play low velocity. Barely hear this stuff. This is getting annoying. So I changed mine to a mute instead of the long notes that they played. Because the library is still loading up. I don't want to waste your time waiting for every single tone to load up. Up the keys just to hear what it sounds like. Now that changes the musicality of everything, but I do like that brighter tone, so that's something I would do usually and go back and fix the music. But for the video, I'm not going to confuse you going back 1,000 times to transpose stuff. Check it with the headphones. I mean, it's a very simple beat, the ooh beat. It's really just the rhythm and the sample they use. Now our sample is different again. Now in the headphones, the keys are a lot louder than my speakers. What I would do to make this a little more aggressive is add like a really dirty tone. So this is beyond kind of the elements from that song. I'm going to add a Moog, and let's do it from the Mini V2. And I'm going to swap out the sub bass for this bass. And we're going to make a really just aggressive tone that we're going to hold. So let's do that. So we can contrast all the kind of happiness from the sample. Because I made mine more musical than their two-note sample. So let's take out the subs. Let's go to Mini V2, send that to track 8. So I want to start from scratch. Now I forget every time how to do it. So let's go to Templates. Synth, here we go. Temp 1 Oscillator. We start with just a sine wave. So I just want to find the root note that I can hold, like boom. So I'm just going to hold the E note for about 4 bars. I don't know why I said E. Let's try G. Now my job is to make this a dirty tone. Now I'm not going to get into everything about sound design. You can learn more about sound design at busyworksbeats.com/sound design. First thing we need to do is lower this oscillator 1 down an octave. So let's do that. I dropped it 2 octaves for that grit and that rumble. Now I'm gonna turn on oscillator 2, turn it to a triangle wave so we can have a smoother tone below this tone. So to hear it, I pulled everything up an octave because I can't hear the other tone for some reason. Sounds, is this on key tracking? Why does it sound like it's not playing the right note? Not sure why this sounds like it's playing a different note, because I'm reading the coarse tuning and it's set to 0. It should be ding. Whatever reason, I want it 2 semitones up. I'm not sure why it sounds weird though. So that's an issue for whatever reason. Let's turn on white noise. Let's add a low pass filter. Trying to decide if I want to do +2 or -5 semitones. This must be key tracking. Let me see. Okay, that's why. It's because oscillator 3 was set to not have key tracking on, which means if I play different notes, it won't play different notes. So if I turn these off, it's going to play the same note regardless. When you turn key tracking on, now it follows the keyboard. So that's why I was getting so confused. I'm like, why isn't it sounding like it's playing the right note? That's because it wasn't set to key tracking. So now let's do that one more time. So now I'm just shaping the tones. That's 2 like low mids. Let's pull that back. Brightness in, because again we want it to sound aggressive, so aggression comes from a lot of harmonic activity. Now we could drop this down an octave for a little bit more rumble. Now I'm just gonna change out the octaves, see which one works best. Okay, now another thing is just holding the bass is going to take away from all the groove. So a lot of people like to hold bass all the time. If you're not side chaining, it's just going to sound like a flat line and very like wobbly. It's not going to sound tight and controlled. So let's add these nice short little notes. So I want to go bump, ba-dum, dum, bum, bum. Let's try that. I can't hear it, so let's pull everything up. I'm also going to change the timing of the plugin. Duplicate that. I want to go bum out just like we did before. Have it hit twice at the end. Bum out. And pull this down an octave. Turn the white noise down a bit. So we're gonna go to the wrench tool, turn up time shift so it's a little bit delayed off the grid. I'm also gonna layer that sub bass in for a little more low end. Goes dark with the filter, let's add another kick just to fill in some of that rhythmic energy that we lost. Might swap out the kick because over the headphones you hear a lot of brightness in my head over my not in my head over my monitors it sounded darker. So let's swap out the kick from the X kit. Let's grab a kick. This is a lot better. We'll be right back. down that delay a little bit. Slightly detune each oscillator, so it's a little bit like creating a unison detune. A little bit of chorusing, but in mono. See if we add some, where are we at here? Glitch 2. No. Okay. I want to do tape stop, but I want to slow it down over time. No, that's too dramatic. Not for this song, it doesn't sound proper. The way I played that Moog was a little West Coast, but that's my own style. So if I have enough time, I'll do a little freestyle in the mind of Meek Mill. Now he has a lot of bars. You know, I don't think I'm sitting here writing 32 bars for a video, but we'll see. Just to show you what it's gonna sound like. Let's move into just adding lyric to it, because I think lyric's gonna brighten it up and just open it up to what it's really gonna sound like, so you get an idea. If you wanna learn more about music production in general, how to get through these type of beats, go to busyworksbeats.com, and we have many different free series you can go through for your style of music that you wanna create. So go to busyworksbeats.com and you can sign up for free. Let's move into part 2.